up your YouTube, search for Stukely Meadows. Watch on your big screen.
Or another device if you're at home.
Get yourself comfy, this could take a while. What a happy scene. Something new every day for your long-term memory. This is so exciting, it is nearly time for a Stukely Assembly. Good morning, everyone, and welcome to Monday. Hey, I haven't gelled up at the start of assembly for ages, so I'm going to do that. Also, I thought we'd have a bit of a change from the white wall, so I've come in front of the curtain. Yeah. Okay. Remember Pobat? Palms? Over the top? Between the fingers, backs of the fingers, and thumbs and wrists, tips of fingers. Do you remember that? Good. For each other we, every day we, to improve we, together we will. Every single Stukely day we focus on. Our Stukely motto is, our Stukely curriculum is, our Stukely plan for home learning is, and four words that make the magic happen. Yes, they do. Right, everyone, welcome to Monday. This is our last week before the Easter break. I know that feels a bit strange. I know it feels weird. Crazy, we've only been in school a couple of weeks and we're nearly breaking up for Easter. It is what it is. I wish we were carrying on because we're suddenly getting momentum back, but we're not. So we've got this week, then we've got a couple of weeks break for Easter, and then when we come back, we're in the summer term. And fingers crossed, the summer term is always one of the happiest at Stukely because we can get outside, we can run more events, we can do different types of clubs, and it's going to be a great term. I know it is. Anyway, it's Monday. You know what we do on a Monday. We're going to talk about curriculum. We're going to talk about learning logs. We have got a who will be triumphant that you are really going to enjoy. Then we've got the usual bits at the end, and then we can start the day or finish the day, because I know some of you watch this in the afternoons. Let's get the music ready. Mr. Jones. Mr. Jones!
Sorry.
Okay, this week's curriculum. This is what you're doing for this final week up until the Easter break. Foundation, you're looking at doubles and halves in your maths this week. You're looking at the O, the U, and the U phonemes in your English this week, and I think you're carrying on your learning about pets and animals, which I know you've really enjoyed so far. Foundation, always some of our favorite learning. Year one, you are having a bit of a spaggy week. We've got lots of spelling, punctuation and grammar ideas this week in year one. You're looking at verbs, plurals, suffixes and prefixes. Be lots of work on spelling there and grammar, definitely. In maths, it says here, Mr. Watley's writing, we're doing a little bit of everything. And I think you're going to draw together lots of maths learning this week to get you ready for the summer term. You're looking at the Easter story in your RE learning this week, and you're doing some Easter craft in your design technology. I've got some good ideas for DT projects, Mr. Watley, but you never want to hear them. Anyway, year two, you are looking at informal letter writing. Interesting. You're looking at sorting 3D shapes in your maths. You're designing a green space in your science learning this week. And you are going to be carrying on with some batik in your art session. You're going to be melting wax I think they've already started that. I can certainly smell it anyway. Last week, that's for sure. Year three, you're writing your Beowulf diary entries. I know you've absolutely loved that. And when I came into Mrs. Boswell's class last week, you were doing some brilliant description. You're looking at fractions in your maths, which Mrs. Franklin said you've been enjoying. You're looking at flowers and skulls in your art. And you're talking about Anglo-Saxon runes in your history year three. Wow, what a great curriculum. Year four, you've got some assessments this week and you're doing your hot task in your writing. Stukely script, good punctuation, great description. Come on, you got this. You're looking at fractions as well in your maths again and doing a couple of assessments around that. You're talking about Edward the Confessor in your history. Brilliant stuff. And you are using research to find out about habitats in your science. Year five. You are finishing and editing your tiger reports this week. Look forward to reading some of those. You're carrying on with fractions, you're multiplying them. You're talking about separating different mixtures in your science, and you're talking about significant Christians in your RE, including Martin Luther King, who lots of you, I hope, have heard about. And finally, year six. Is it the truth? Is it a jape? With year six, we've got to go and turn to landscape. Sorry. You're talking about ratio in your maths. Could be tricky, but I think you might quite enjoy it. You're writing a persuasive letter in your Sherlock Holmes unit in English. You're talking about how Britain defended itself in your history, I'm guessing from in World War II. And you're talking about the circulatory. You're talking about that system and what happens to it during exercise. It's gonna be brilliant. That's the curriculum for this week. Lots to do, isn't there? We're now going to bounce straight into learning logs. Give me 5 seconds. Only needed three. Right, learning logs. We do this every week. Last week when we did this, not every learning log was in the classes, and quite a lot of people hadn't done their sentences. I am really hoping, I'm really positive that I'm going to see more sentence writing and more reading this week. Please tell me. Get your learning logs ready. Come on, Stukely. 1, 2, 3, show your learning logs to me. Teachers, I need to know number of children in, number of learning logs in, and number of learning logs completed. I really hope it's more than last week. Just a reminder for you all, I haven't done this before, but some of you are forgetting. In your learning log, every week, there should be a sentence for the Monday. Now, if you don't actually do it on the Monday, that's okay. This just gives you an idea. We need a sentence for the Monday, a sentence for the Tuesday, a sentence for the Wednesday, a sentence for the Thursday, a sentence for the Friday. You should have read 5 times, so that'll be 5 ticks. And then we say that Numbots or Rockstars is only 2 times. There are 3 boxes here. Sorry about that. But that's what a week should look like. I'll be coming around this afternoon, to have a check to see how we're doing in learning logs and how we've done just reading books at home, definitely doing AR quizzes. I look forward to that. I really like to see what people are reading. Makes me happy. That's learning logs. You know what you need to do every week. Now, we are going headlong into who will be triumphant. I went out into the Stukely corridors. I chose 3 incredible people and I said, come to the hall and we're going to try and be triumphant. And do you know what? They came and this is what happened.
Who will be? Who will be? Who will be triumphant? Who will be? Who will be? Who will be triumphant? Who will be? Who will be? Who will be triumphant? Who will be? Who will be? Who will be triumphant?
Hello, everybody, and welcome back to the Who Will Be Triumphant studio. But who have we got today? I'll tell you who we've got. We've got Mrs. Warby, Mrs. Provis, and Mrs. Davis. What have they got in common? Well, I'll tell you what they've got in common. None of them wanted to come and do this. Not one of them. Only joking. What have they got in common? They all asked me on the WhatsApp if they could take part, and I said, yes, you can. Anyway, they're here. What have they got to do? I've given them all a sheet of paper. Ladies, wave your paper at us. Okay, they've all got a sheet of A3 paper. I'm going to give them 60 seconds, and using only their hands, they have to turn that sheet of paper into the longest strip of paper that they can. They can fold, they can rip, they can screw it up, they can do whatever they like with it, but it has to turn into a long piece of paper that is all in one piece. What happens if they rip it, I hear you ask? Well, if it rips, they have to get rid of this bit they've ripped off, and they only have one bit left. So they have to be very careful not to rip this piece of paper. They've got 60 seconds. Who do you think will be triumphant and have the longest piece of paper by the very end? You do know they've all taken part in this before. Do you remember Mrs. Warby took part in the anagram challenge? Mrs. Provis took part in the carrot challenge, and Mrs. Davis took part in the higher or lower challenge. Oh, okay. Right, ladies, your time starts now! Seconds left. It feels very powerful in here right now. A few seconds left to put the finishing touches to this long piece of paper. One, and stop! Ladies, stop there. Right. I'm out of breath and I haven't even been trying to get a long piece of paper. Right, ladies, could you do as I asked and lay your piece of paper out, starting from the line on the floor that we discussed earlier? Okay, we're ready to see who has got the longest piece of paper. Okay, Mrs. Warby, Mrs. Provis, and there we have Mrs. Davis. That means that Mrs. Davis is triumphant! What a performance that is from Mrs. Davis. She came in here, she really didn't want to. The class was saying, go on, Mrs. Davis, you can do this. And she's done it. Thank you, all three of you, for taking part. See you next time on Who Will Be Triumphant.
Who will be, who will be, who will be triumphant? Who will be, who will be, who will be triumphant?
I'll tell you what, I think that was the 20th Who Will Be Triumphant that we've done. I think we've done about 20, I'm sure we have. I'm not sure which is my favourite out of all of them, but that one was definitely up there. Mrs. Davis was absolutely made up. She sent me 45 WhatsApp messages over the weekend, just said how excited she was to be a part of the school and win. Very, very excited. Well done, Mrs. Davis. Well done, everyone else. Shout outs, let's go. First of all, I think this is our second George in year six who's got his AR Millionaire. George R, Sycamore class. Top work, George. Smashed a million. Wonder if we can get another million in before you move on. Little challenge for you there, George. Birthdays. Oh my goodness me. We've got four today. Is that a Suitley record? I think it probably is. We say happy birthday to Jacob in year five, Noah in year four, Sahana in year one, and Ella Rose in year two. Happy birthday, all four of you. You're with friends today, which is great, and you'll see some family and then hopefully a few more family over the next few weeks. Enjoy it. It's great to have you with us in school to celebrate your big day. And once again, it won't be a birthday you forget. In fact, your last birthday would have been in a lockdown. This is your second birthday in a lockdown-ish. I suppose we are. We are still. It doesn't feel like we're completely locked down, but we are. Okay, have a good day, you four. Oh, yes. Last week on Friday, I showed you a cheeky little picture of Bo. And said, I'll tell you, well, let me tell you about Bo. So Bo did some work on the gorilla story by Anthony Brown. He did it, I think at the start of the year, remote. He did it remotely, really enjoyed it. His family sent off his story to a Tottenham Hotspur, Spurs football club. Harry Kane, you heard of Harry Kane? Yeah, Harry Kane, read it. Genuine, sent Bo a letter. So Bo's got a letter from Harry Kane, and I think some of the other Tottenham players had a look at it as well. He's got a letter and a few goodies brought to Bo's house by one of the Spurs coaches, one of their coaching staff. So that picture that I showed you, here it is again. That picture is of Bo after somebody from Spurs Football Club has driven to his house, given him some goodie bags and said, Harry Kane loved your story. It's true, I'm not making it up. Great. Bo was over the moon. Top work, Bo, really pleased for you. What a little treat. What a little treat. Creative challenges. Thank you to everybody that took part in Mrs. Page's challenge, which was to show us the Stukely values in words using whatever you liked. Here are the highlights. Most important 60 seconds are coming up now. The most important 60 seconds are coming up now. That didn't quite work. Anyway, most important 60 seconds. If there's anybody who still wants to buy Easter egg raffle tickets, they're still for sale. Send your money in an envelope with Easter egg raffle written on it, and we can still sort you some tickets out and the teeny weeny chocolate eggs. If you haven't been given your teeny weeny chocolate eggs yet, you should be getting them today. We sold a lot more tickets than I thought we would. Also, Oakleaf Bookshop is open this week. Some of you will be coming tomorrow, some of you will be coming on Thursday. It's loads of books, lots of other book-related things as well. If your teachers will tell you if you've got any credit, if you've got any money to spend. If you haven't, you can bring some in an envelope with Oakleaf Bookshop written on it. If you don't want to take part, you don't have to, it's up to you. But that's happening this week. And then after the Easter break, we'll be straight back into the bookshop as well. Okay? I think that's about it. Have a good day, everyone. Look forward to seeing you around school.